Hello, hello, hello. Today is December 10, 2022. Solutions to problem 130. Strange snow patterns in my garden. First of all, around two trees, there was a circle of snow left over, whereas anywhere else on the grass, the snow had already melted. I realized already then, and I mentioned that in the problem, that I know the solution. And indeed, I have confirmed that solution. I have a very large garden, and it is mowed every 2 weeks, starting in April all the way up to October. Very fancy tractor, very fancy cutting devices. Takes him an hour and a half to do my entire garden. But he cannot get close to the stems of trees, because that's the way that his tractor is designed. So he has to stay away from the stem about 2 feet. But how does he cut the grass now? Well, he has a very special tool, which many of you know. He holds it in his hand. It's also electrically powered. It is a disc that rotates very fast, and at the end of the disc, the circumference, is a plastic wire, sometimes two. And that cuts the grass. And so he has that in his hand, and then he walks around the tree and he cuts the grass. Now, it is very possible that in doing that, he may actually go a little bit deeper than the grass, and he may actually bring up some soil. That's what I suspected. That's the only way I could explain why those two trees had still snow around them. And of course, I was able to confirm that my suspicion was correct by taking a picture later when there was no snow. And you will see indeed that the soil has been disturbed, and in this case, of course, by his hand-driven tool. So if you hang on, you will see those pictures. So that's clearly the explanation. The explanation for these strange snow patterns that were in irregular tracks, that was obvious to me right away. We have moles here. Moles have no eyes. They live underground. But where they walk, they push up the ground. And so it makes a very small dent upwards. Could be as high as 2 inches, 4 or 5 centimeters. I know you don't like inches. And I will show you a picture of one of them, and then you'll be convinced that that is the reason why the snow often on those tunnels, I call them tunnels, stays a little longer than melting outside. The soil has been pushed up a little bit, different angle to the sun, maybe even some soil has come up. You will see from the picture that I'm going to show you shortly that there is no question. So we have both answers now. Why there is still snow around the trees has to do with the way that my grass is cut, and why there is snow along these strange patterns, that is due to moles. Hang in there, I have to change my camera to show you those pictures that I promised I would show you. So here you see one of the two trees that had a circle of snow still around it. And you can see here very clearly that the soil is visible. So the person who cut the grass with using a different tool, went a little bit too deep here, and that is where the snow, clearly, you can also see it here, clearly didn't melt as fast as the rest. But there's a difference in soil, that is the reason. Next one. You see the same thing. Oh, you see it also here. So he also hit the ground here too hard. And you see here very clearly that his grinding tool went a little deeper in than just the grass. So the soil is different, not too surprising, therefore, that there is a difference in time that it takes for the snow to melt. Here you see a dramatic case of what I call a mole tunnel. So the mole was below the ground here, pushing it up. And when there is snow, apparently it melts sooner here than it melts there. Maybe for a variety of reasons. One could be the sun, because there is a partly shadow here. And there could be also a reason that sometimes the soil below the grass comes to the surface. All right, no one has this problem correct. I don't blame you, because who knows how my grass is being cut here in Connecticut. Many of you tried, no one has the correct answer. I don't blame you for that. I love to create problems that are related to my garden. I do that often, and I will keep doing that. And we will be friends no matter what. That's always a given with my garden or without my garden.